Before we decide either to save the planet or to destroy it, we pause for a moment of silence. I mean real silence.
And here comes the problem. The failure of one of our networks. It's an information network, and it's called money, about which we have the most unbelievable superstitions.
Truth is, we are in the middle of a global crisis, the likes of which we have never seen before, or are to ever see again. And the choices we make now will determine the fate of life for millennia.
As a society, we've grown so distant from what we call nature as if it's separate from us, and that's why we're killing it and exploiting it and constantly extracting from Mother Earth instead of regenerating.
Todo ser humano está enfocado al dinero.
For the vast majority of human history, people did not use money.
The real conspiracy is that any of this is at all normal, that this is any way to live, competing endlessly just so that we can survive. The real conspiracy is that any other way of life is beyond imagination.
That's the challenge of our world. You know, we're calling it a war of values, and we're currently losing.
The United States perpetuates this daily violence and subjugation, not to spread democracy or human rights, but to extract resources and protect capital.
A certain group of people bears the brunt of harshness throughout history, man.
The deadliest form of violence is poverty.
Our system right now is predicated on stepping on somebody's face so somebody else can stand up. And these things don't have to exist this way.
And that's basically what COVID was. It was an amalgamation of all that coming together to hopefully make it more clear to people that what was normal was never okay to begin with.
Welcome to the heart of the disease.
When we go upstream from the challenges we face today, climate change, biodiversity loss, war, conflict, inequality, we find very deep held economic ideology.
If you lived with a person as unstable as capitalism, you would have moved out long ago.
So as you get your bonus, I ask you, is it worth it?
No!
Profiting off everything we do and driving the endless growth that always means more consumption, extraction, waste, pollution, environmental destruction, all the time, or it all falls apart.
This isn't somebody soothsaying and saying, you know, the revolution is here. If we continue down this path, then what we have is collapse.
It's not an exaggeration to say that we're heading into the end of the world as we know it.
Bank is closed.
We've been trying to warn you guys for so many decades. We're gonna lose everything.
We rise for the planet!
And it's all for money.
Let the harm that has been done to this world as your power to never give up and keep fighting.
This is our time. This is our world.
We are not protesters.
We are protectors.
And to create justice, it's got to come from below, and then the law can then follow.
The machine don't know how to work with empathy. It's like putting water in the machine when the machine needs oil. The machine needs blood and dead bodies, man. We need to build a new machine, man.
Why aren't we using our own innovations to improve the quality of life of everybody across the board?
And that is the best way to describe change. Designing our way out of this unsustainable paradigm is the only way forward.
To create, to innovate, and imagine and build those alternative worlds.
A resource-based economy.
Automation.
Regenerative agriculture.
Artificial intelligence.
Reform communities.
Participatory network.
Share the abundance.
An open source world.
Disaster collectivism.
Finally, a real economy.
Any other alternative is gunned down or blasted away or maligned and propagandized as socialism, communism, oh, that's utopian. All this nonsense to keep us from just trying to make the world better.
To create a real movement that can radically transform the existence for everybody on the planet, we have to remember that our destinies are completely and intimately linked. That is the starting point.
People who are fed up with all this and see the problems, they see that it's not sustainable, they see that we need to do something. Now, we're creating an alternative system here.
We have more than enough to provide everyone on this planet with a high standard of living if we focused on working together. If not, we perish.
This is so much bigger than any of us.
Why are we allowing a system that's going down to take us down with it?
What is a revolution? I can tell you what it's not. It's not the bloody, volatile, warmongering. Revolution is quite literally just a form of evolution.
In order to prevent the unthinkable, we must do the impossible.
It's too late for reform. We need to transform. We have the science, we have the technology, we have the resources, the life, the people to make a real change. It's time to grow up.
All are responsible for all, meaning all human beings are responsible for each other, meaning we are all responsible for each other.
If we put our collective efforts together, the only limit is our imagination.
Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly.